Hi and welcome. So in this video, I want to show you how to embed a MailChimp form on your WordPress website. And we will be starting from the MailChimp homepage. So this is the page that you'll most likely see as soon as you log into MailChimp. So first of all, we need to go to a list. You choose one list for which list you want to use as the place for collecting the signups. The signups that will happen through the form that you will embed. So the first step, the very first step, let's go to lists. Now, I can choose any one of these lists as the list which I will be using for collecting the signups. So let me choose this first one. So I don't have subscribers, that doesn't matter. What we're interested in is the signup forms. So once I'm here, I will click on signup forms. And then I will go to embedded forms. So as you can see, we are here on the embedded forms, and if you scroll down, you will see here is our embed code. So I can see if I come up here, I can see that there's a new form here which is called the horizontal. So this was not there the last time I did a video about embedding forms. So this is one of those forms which you can just use. You can just come down here and take this code, and it will give you an horizontal form. So if you want a form which is horizontal, you can just come here, click on horizontal, and then copy the code here and paste it on your website. But we are interested in the classic form. So this is our classic form. It has all these different fields, but we want to come here and say show only required fields. And once we say we only want to see the required fields, it only shows us the email and the name. So we also have these other parts. You can, from the last video that I did on embedded forms, I did an explanation of this. You can go back to that part and see what I said about each of these. For instance, if you want to change the title of the form, you can do so here. You can also remove this title. And you can see once I click outside, the title which was here disappears. So just with that, here's our embed code. And before I copy the code, so I can see this is back after the form reloaded itself, it confused this. So I'll click this one again. And then I can click here to see if this happens. If this happens, well and good. That means this is how this is going to work once I embed it. So I will scroll down, and then I will copy this embed code, then I will come to my WordPress website, and let me just create a new page. I will create a new page. Let's say you want to create a signup page on your website. So that's what I'm doing. I'll just create a new page and copy the embed code into that page. So I can call this page sign up, and I want to copy the, I want to paste in this code from MailChimp inside here. And for me to paste code into the WordPress editor, I will just change it back. I will go and up here and change it to text. Then I will paste in that. All of it, I'll just paste the entire thing in there. And if I publish the page, after publishing the page, I will go and view the page. And you can see that the form has been embedded here. And the reason my form seems like it has been styled is because I have another form from MailChimp down here. And I wrote some custom CSS for this one. So the custom CSS for this form is affecting the form that I've just embedded. This is a form that I've just embedded. So if you paste yours, it will not look anything like mine because it is using the styles from the default styles from MailChimp. So in this video, I've shown you how you can embed a MailChimp form. So the first step is getting to the list, and then you go to the signup form, go to embedded forms, and then you land here, and here you can choose the form that you want. In my case, I've used the classic form. We have the super slim, which only has the email. This one only has, if you look at this, it only has the email address. Then we have the new one, which is the horizontal, which has the email, and the signup is horizontal to the form itself, horizontal to the input box itself. Then we have the naked one, which doesn't have any styling. You'll have to create styling for this, or you can just use this one the way it is. If you want your page to load really fast, this would be a nice way to go. So that's it for this video. If you have any questions, feel very free to let me know, and I will see what I can do to answer them.